The Lord's wanting to show some of us His glory. He's wanting to visit you right now. He's wanting to touch you and strengthen you and help you and lead you and guide you. His presence is in this place today. His anointing and His grace, His healing power, His anointing. Oh, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, right now we speak peace. That peace that passes all understanding. And that peace has a name. And His name is Jesus.
Yes, hallelujah.
I believe in You. You're the God of miracles. Ooh. I believe
hallelujah.
In You. I believe
hallelujah.
In You. You're the God of miracles.
Praise Your name.
Hallelujah.
In
You. You're the God of miracles.
Get Your presence.
Get Your presence. In You. I believe in You. You're the God of
Hallelujah. He's the God of miracles. And we believe in You today.
I believe in You. to come. The power of the risen one, the God who brings the dead to life. You're the God of miracles. You're the God of miracles. The God who was and is to come. The power of the risen one.
Hallelujah.
The God who brings the dead to life. You're the God of miracles. You're the God of miracles. I believe in you. I believe in you. You're the God of miracles. I believe in you. I believe in you. You're the God of miracles. We know, yes. We know.
He's
we
the God of miracles.
We believe
hallelujah.
In you.
Hallelujah.
You're the God of
miracles.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Hallelujah. Praise your holy name, Jesus.
That which you thought was dead, he's bringing back to life. Because he's the God of miracles.
Yes, hallelujah.
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 That which you thought was dead,
yes.
He's bringing the dead
hallelujah.
Back to life. Hallelujah. Dreams, he's bringing back
hallelujah.
Dreams to life.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Why? Because he's the God of miracles today.
Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Lord. I believe in you. Hallelujah, Lord. That nothing is impossible with you. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to your name. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. There's nothing impossible. Whatever you think today is impossible, it is not impossible. And God is bringing it back to life today. We're speaking life into it right now. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because he's the God of miracles.
You're the God of miracles.
Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Father. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for visiting us, reminding us once again, Lord, that you are the God of miracles, that you're bringing what is dead back to life, that you are restoring that which has been stolen.
Yes,
You are redeeming that which is lost. You're filling, Father God, that which is empty. And Father God, you're pouring out.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. You're pouring out in these last days. Your Holy Spirit. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. Oh, we praise you today in this place. For he has not given you a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. Amen. And he says, speak it out with boldness. Speak it out and declare it with boldness, because you don't have a spirit of timidity, but you have a spirit of power.
Amen. Amen.
And authority. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As we try. Amen. Go ahead, brother. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
He's somebody that you can rely upon. Call on his name and he will hear you. Amen. Oh, praise his holy name. Be turning in your Bibles to the last book of the Bible, Revelations chapter 4. As we transition from this place into heaven. Amen. So in the next few moments, it's your job to help me to preach. Amen. It's always easier when the Holy Spirit is here and you sense his presence. And you know that he's right there by your side. And our job today is to rejoice when I say something good. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. Revelations chapter 4 and verse 1 says, and after these things I looked, and behold, a door standing open in heaven. And the first voice which I heard was unusual. It was like a trumpet speaking to me, saying, come up here, and I will show you things which must take place after this. Immediately, the next verse says, immediately I was in the Spirit, and behold, the throne set in heaven, and one who sat on the throne. Oh, hallelujah. I want to talk a little bit today about that voice that calls us and says to us, come up here. We need to get a little bit of heaven on our mind, amen? We need to come up here and hear and have the presence and to be in the Spirit and to know and to know no fear, yes, and to know where God is going. And to know beyond a shadow of a doubt today that you serve a God. Hallelujah, the God of miracles. Praise his holy name. I'm talking today to some precious people who've been strained and have been stretched to their limits emotionally. I'm talking to people who have been hounded by a physical pain or been harassed by financial difficulties, and their mind is, they feel like sometimes your mind is in a pressure cooker. Amen? You're thinking, man, when is this going to be done? Because it's been cooking a long time. Amen? It's like one of those Instapots. Amen. Like to be an Insta. Amen. But the Bible tells us in Colossians chapter 3, verses 1 and 3, it says, you know, it talks about our mind and where our mind is. And I don't know about you, but when I was growing up as a young Christian, I was told that, for one, they'd call me the walking Bible, and they'd call me, you know, this and that. But sometimes they'd be called, you know, he's so heavenly mindedly, he's no earthly good. And I'm thinking, I didn't say it, but I was thinking, you're so earthly minded, you ain't no heavenly good. Amen. But here, Paul is, he's telling us, you know, that we need to have the mind of Christ, to be heavenly minded, and to see and seek those things that are above. The apostle wanted the Colossians to desire and to pursue and to run after heavenly things so much, he said, to set your mind on things above. Think about these things. Because today there's so many things you can think about that's going to run you into the ragged areas, right? And the ragged edge and the place, you know, if you concentrate only on those, you need to reflect upon the heavenly and contemplate heavenly things, and to set your sights, the New Living Translation says, to set your sights on the reality of heaven. Amen. Heaven, the spiritual realm, is more real than the physical realm. It's hard for us to understand that because we have physical eyes that see, right? But the Lord says that he looks on the heart, but man looketh on the outward appearance. When you look at somebody, most of the time you're looking at them physically, you don't see the spiritual. But that's the only thing God looks at, is the heart. He looks at our heart and he understands who we are and, you know, our pursuits and our minds and our thoughts. But here's Paul, you know, he's getting the Colossians to focus upon heaven, to think about those things which are above and not the things that are on this earth, and to reflect upon them and to think about them and to focus upon them. And, oh, hallelujah, sometimes, you know, we get sidetracked in this life. We look and we listen and we hear too many things that we don't need to be looking and listening to, and we get distracted from focusing upon what we need to be focusing upon. The Bible tells us to think upon what these things, good things, and sing psalms and hymns and encourage one another and strengthen one another in the Lord, and let your words such be that they are life to those that you're talking to and not death, but allow your words to go forth to bring life. And we need to have life today. I don't know about you, but I'm thinking that's a good thing. But I'm talking today to, you know, people who have been humbled by sometimes domestic disharmony. It's been trouble in the family and in marriages and struggles and difficulties. And Satan wants to keep us, really, our attention on our problems and off of our promises. He wants us to focus upon the problems instead of the victories. He wants us to focus upon the pressure instead of the providence of God and the power of God and the prayer to God and the miracles of God and the presence of God. Because we serve a mighty God. Now, yesterday was the return. Here's the Washington Mall up here, what it looked like in Washington, D.C., right there. Thousands upon thousands, 50,000 plus people were there praying for our nation, praying for our president, praying for, you know, the things that are coming, because we're at a crux, a place in America where it's either God's blessing or God's judgment. And it was just a wonderful, it's a wonderful thing to see Christians gather together to pray and to seek his face There was not only those gathering in the Washington Mall, but there was millions around the whole world that were participating through the simulcast as we were here in this church. But it was all around the world, and everybody was crying out and praying and seeking God to, hallelujah, to renew the land, to bring revival, to bring hallelujah, His presence and His glory. But when I was looking at that picture and we were singing, "Show Me Your Glory," I seen a vision in my mind in heaven. I seen, oh hallelujah, the millions upon millions upon millions of angels. Oh hallelujah, clothed in robes of white. Hallelujah, around the throne room of God. His presence and His glory. He was showing me to, hallelujah, that they are more that are with us than those that be against us. Oh praise be to God. He, hallelujah, in this place today, show me your glory, because He is a God of miracles. He is a God of miracles in many sense. Hallelujah, kind of a shifting. Hallelujah, how can there not be a shifting when God's people set their face to prayer, to seek Him? Oh, hallelujah, for something to change, something to happen. And I believe, hallelujah, that in the annals of heaven, in the very courtyards, oh, glory be to God, where the greatest judge of all sits. Oh, praise be to God, the heavens were shifted. Oh, praise God, and He's about to pour out His glory and His anointing and His presence and His touch upon, oh hallelujah, His bride, His church, His people. And then to go out into the highways and the byways and the hedges proclaiming that Jesus Christ is coming soon. Oh praise be to His holy name. Oh praise His holy name. We need to get our thoughts and our minds upon the glorious realities of a heaven that awaits us, not only in the future where we will be spiritually, but right now. Oh, hallelujah, I'm reminded of the angel. Oh, hallelujah, when Jesus, when they seen Jesus ascending into heaven, they looked up and were gazing. And two, it says that two of those angels that I just saw were standing next to them, and they said, "Brethren, why stand you there gazing?" You know why they said that? Because the kingdom of God was about to be inside of them. You see, the kingdom is here today, inside of you. Oh, hallelujah. The kingdom of God today is inside of you, is living inside of you. Oh, praise be to God. Oh, He wants us to set our thoughts and our minds. He says, come up here and see and get in the Spirit like John on that day. Come up here. Oh, praise be to God. Jesus said, I go to prepare a place for you. And where I go, oh, hallelujah, He says, I'll come again, but I will come, and you will join me. Oh, hallelujah, John. Now, the revelator was, he was ostracized to the Isle of Patmos. God had saved him from a boiling pot of oil. Now, I don't know how many you've cooked with oil. I am thinking if I was in a pot of oil, I'm not coming out. But see, God had another plan for John. You see, John was the last apostle alive. And God was like, John, you're going to have to write another book before you go, so I'm going to surround you and protect you. He ain't going to be able to kill you. So they, you know, here's the mind of the devil. Okay, I can't kill you. I'm going to ostracize you on the Isle of Patmos, thinking it's going to be the worst thing for you ever. But God, you see, God has a different plan. That which the enemy means to destroy you, God uses. Oh, hallelujah. God uses. Hallelujah. God uses. And he used John being on the Isle of Patmos to become John the Revelator, where he became, he said, Jesus said, come up here. And John was brought up into the heavenlies in the spiritual realm to be shown, no glory be to God. Hallelujah. What is in heaven and what was to take place in the end times. But guess what? Oh, hallelujah, we can get in the spirit and likewise and go into the heavenlies and be with Jesus and putting our mind upon him, reflecting upon him, focusing upon him and seeing, the glory of God. Hallelujah, in the presence of God in our lives so that we might overcome these difficulties that we face. You see, God allowed John to see a door. He allowed John to hear a voice. He allowed John's eyes to be opened. You know, sometimes some of us can see, but we need to be blinded so we can see. Some of us are blinded, and some of us need to see. Oh, sometimes we think we can see, but we can't see. We can't really see the infathomable love of a heavenly Father that loved us so much that he sent his only begotten Son. Hallelujah, that the power of God would come to this earth to save you and to save me. See, many try to say the Christian's thoughts and minds are nothing but a state of mind. It ain't a state of mind. It's a presence. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, glory be to God. Oh, praise his holy name. I don't know about you, but if I've been on the mission field and I've traveled in different places around the world, and I know that when I was in those different places, I was not from there, okay? I was sent there, but I was not from there. Oh, hallelujah. I knew that I was an ambassador of Christ. Hallelujah. I was not from there, but I was sent there. Well, guess what? Oh, hallelujah, Christian, today, you're not from this world. Oh, hallelujah, but you've been sent here to be an ambassador of Christ, and your mind needs to be up in heaven where your heavenly Father is, because you can't do the works, you can't do the miracles, you can't do and perform the calling that God has called you to do and to be unless you are like-minded like your heavenly Father is, and not think about and focus upon the things here on earth. Jesus said, my Father's house is, he said, it's full of many mansions. He says, if it were not so, I'd tell you. But I'm telling you right now, it's chock full of mansions. And there's one waiting for you. He says, if it weren't so, I'd tell you, okay? Yeah. Amen. 1 Thessalonians 4 says, for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with a voice of an archangel, and he's not going to need a sound system, hallelujah, that's cranked up to maximum. When he shouts, the whole world is going to hear his voice. And the trump of God will sound. And it says, and then the dead in Christ shall rise first. And we who are alive and remain will be caught up together to meet him in the clouds, in the air. And so shall we ever. Oh, hallelujah. And then shall we forever. And then shall we forever, ever, 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 ever. Hallelujah. We shall forever be with the Lord. Oh, hallelujah, praise his holy name. It doesn't end there, though. Then he adds this little P.S. He says, wherefore, the reason I said all of that is to comfort one another with these words. I've come today to comfort you. I've come today to encourage you. Oh, hallelujah. I've come today, oh, hallelujah, to help us to remember. Oh, hallelujah, the goal that is set before us. Oh, hallelujah, to remember. Hallelujah, that your working is not in vain here on earth. Your working, oh, glory be to God, is not in vain. Oh, praise be to God, your working today and ministering and moving is not in vain. Oh, hallelujah, because the Bible says store up for yourselves treasures in heaven where moth and rust doth not corrupt. Oh, hallelujah. See, when you're doing the work and the calling of God, you're storing up for yourselves. Oh, glory God be to God, rewards in heaven. And you're storing up for yourselves where moth and rust cannot corrupt. Oh, hallelujah. And maybe the tanking of the world system can't make your retirement go backwards. Oh, no. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. The stock market does not affect, oh, hallelujah, your good works. They've been recorded in the books. Glory be to God. They've been recorded in the books. Oh, hallelujah, the books of life, the book of remembrance, all the books. Hallelujah, praise and be to our Lord and our Savior. Your name is written down in the Lamb's Book of Life today. And guess what? You have a new name. Oh, praise be to God today. I don't know what your name is, and I don't know what my name is, and I might sound a little crazy right now, but guess what? We have a new name written down in glory. Praise be to His holy name. I've come this morning to comfort you and to remind you that heaven is a real place. Heaven is a real place. Heaven is a real place. Oh, praise be to His holy name. Now, John the Revelator was in prison. He was suffering on the Isle of Patmos. But guess what? Oh, hallelujah, you might be in the midst of suffering today, but I'm telling you, oh, glory be to God, when the Spirit of God falls upon you, it says, oh, hallelujah, He was in the Spirit, and God's Spirit came upon Him, and He saw a glimpse of heaven. And I'm saying today, it doesn't matter if you're in the boiling oil, the cauldron, hallelujah, you're in the pressure cooker, the Instapot, oh, hallelujah, in that convection oven. It doesn't matter, because when the Spirit of God begins to fall upon you, God will give you a glimpse of His glory. God will give you a glimpse of His presence. Oh, hallelujah, praise be to His holy name today. You see, God gave John a revelation for us. That's why John was told to write it down. Write down the vision, because God wanted to preserve it to encourage you and to encourage me. Hallelujah. Praise His holy name, for the just shall not live by sight, but by faith, and the faith that we have today. Oh, declares and says to a dying world that God is the one that brings death back to life. Oh, praise His holy name, the God of heaven. Hallelujah, is alive today and well. And Jesus Christ is sitting on the throne room of God. And there's multitudes upon multitudes upon multitudes. Oh, of white robed, oh, hallelujah, saints, but also the angels from heaven. Hallelujah, the greater is He that is in us than he that is in the world. It says, lift up your eyes and see. Lift up your eyes and see. Oh, hallelujah, lift up your eyes and see. One day you'll be home. In Revelation chapter 7 and verse 15, it says, He who sits on the throne will shelter them in his presence forever and forever and forever and forever and forever and forever. Oh, hallelujah, for eternity. There is no end. Hallelujah to eternity. We're living in the time frame of time, but one day we won't even think about time anymore, because we will be sitting in the presence of our heavenly Savior and our heavenly Lord. Oh, this is a beautiful picture. Oh, hallelujah. A beautiful picture today of what's living inside of you. See, the disciples, I started to think this morning when I was thinking, Lord, when did them there first disciples get saved or get their new spirit? Spirit born again? When did they? Because they didn't seem to have a clue a lot of times spiritually. You know what was happening? They thought when Jesus rose, we came up from the grave, and there was 500 of them around Jesus. Okay, Jesus, you came back to life. You're gonna smash the Romans now, bring in a new kingdom, a new political kingdom. Didn't understand. Maybe they weren't born again yet. They had the promise, right? But there's coming a day when we will be home forever. Amen? Completely home. He says, I go to prepare a place for you. I go to prepare a place for you. I go to prepare a place for you. Oh, hallelujah. And then in heaven, you'll be able to serve God just as you wished you could here on earth. It says in Revelation 7 and verse 15, they are before the throne of God and serve him day and night in his temple. Oh, a lot of us want to, right here on earth, we want to just serve God 24/7, and we should. Don't get me wrong. What I'm saying is we'll be able to do it perfectly in heaven. We won't be thinking, oh, Lord, I got to do this and I got to do that. I got homework to do and I got to do the dishes and I got to mow the lawn and I got to go to work and I got to, woo, stop it. Amen. But in heaven, we'll be able to serve him just like we wish we could day and night. Oh, there'll be no tiredness there. Oh, hallelujah. Praise be to God. Oh, hallelujah. Praise his holy name. We'll be tired no more. We won't know what it's like to be tired. What is that about? Amen. Woo! Glory. Give somebody give a shout today. Oh, hallelujah. No more of those B vitamins. Amen. No tiredness. Oh, here we go. On this earth, we go through seasons of feeling distant from God. I don't know. Have you ever felt that way? But when we're in heaven, day and night, night and day, we will be serving the Lord our God. And in heaven, oh, hallelujah, I really like this. And Christ will lead you into increasing joy. Woo! Revelation 7 and verse 16 says, the Lamb in the midst of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of living water. Oh, praise his holy name. Oh, go ahead and get yourself a big old 64-ounce mug and dip into that spring of living water, and then go ahead and guzzle it full of joy. Oh, joy unspeakable and full of glory. Praise his holy name. You may think heaven's going to be a wonderful place where I'm going to discover all kinds of marvelous things. Yes, it will be wonderful. It will be majestical. But John is telling us it's better than that. It's above and beyond. Oh, hallelujah. It's above and beyond what we can even imagine. Oh, praise. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, praise be to God. We'll probably be moving from one place to the next by thought. I don't know. Oh, praise be to His holy name. I'm going to Jupiter. I don't know. I mean, you know what I'm talking about here. But Christ is the great shepherd, and these are the promises of God. He feeds us, and we'll never again be hungry. Oh, hallelujah. He strengthens us where we'll never again, oh, hallelujah, be weak, but He will be our source and our strength and our joy. Praise His holy name today. And in heaven, all of your wounds will be healed. All of your wounds. In Revelation 7 and 17, it says, God will wipe away every tear from their eye. Probably going to get rid of the tear ducts. They're not needed no more. Amen. The baggage that we carry around in life, no more. Get rid of your bags. Just go ahead and get rid of your Samsonite, you know, those big old bags you bought to carry around that baggage. Amen. We're finally, the pain that you suffered, you'll suffer no more. The battles you're waging, you'll battle no more. Oh, hallelujah. I want to eat from the fruit of the tree of life. 1,865 times in the Old Testament, heaven is mentioned. 316 times in the New Testament. It's mentioned so much that we ought to be talking about it. We ought to be singing about heaven. We ought to be preaching about it, amen? We ought to be shouting about heaven. We ought to be testifying about heaven. We ought to have heaven on our mind, as a matter of fact. Peter said in 1 Peter 1 and 4, he says, we have been given an inheritance that fadeth not away, but it is reserved in heaven, wherein you should greatly rejoice in this hope. You should greatly rejoice. Oh, hallelujah, rejoice, and let hell know. Oh, hallelujah, that you're going to heaven, that Jesus Christ has redeemed you, and He has the keys to death, hell, and the grave, and greatly should be your voice proclaiming, oh, hallelujah, that the devil is defeated, the devil is under your feet, the devil, hallelujah, has no authority in your life, but God Almighty is raising you up today. I'm not going to let the devil take heaven off my mind. You see what here, Beelzebub? Jesus is alive. Hallelujah. Jesus rose from the grave and He says, I'm coming back again and I'm going to take you with me when I do. And you'll never have a tear or sorrow again. And that place is called heaven. Amen. Somebody right now greatly rejoice in the knowledge that we one day will be with Him forever and ever and ever. Give the Lord a shout of praise forever and ever. Hallelujah. I'm feeling mighty fine because I got heaven on my mind. Oh, praise be to God. If you're depressed, if you're on depression pills, I'm going to tell you how to get off of them. If maybe you're in the mully grubs or those places you don't need to be, guess what? Get heaven on your mind. Get heaven on your mind because it is there that God touches us and strengthens us. I'm feeling mighty fine because I got heaven on my mind. Now, if you could travel the speed of light, hang on, you might be able to eventually. You could get to the planet Mercury. Okay, speed of light. You could get to planet Mercury in 4.5 minutes. Okay, it's 57 million miles away. If you could travel the speed of light and you wanted to go to Jupiter, like I said earlier, It's 390 million miles away. It'd take a whopping 35 minutes. Okay? You wanted to go to Neptune. Who wants to go to Neptune? 2.7 billion miles away. Or Pluto. That's another billion on top of that. So it's going to take you a couple hours, all right? But I love the fact of what John says. He says here, when the door opened and I heard a voice say, come up here. See, heaven isn't immediately you're there. Immediately you're there. Because heaven's inside of you. So you're already there. Sometimes some of us don't know what we know because we don't know what we should know. Yeah? I heard this saying the other day, you know, you wear one of those masks, it's a good time to be a ventriloquist. Yeah. All right, caught me. But it says in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, we shall be changed. How many of you are waiting for that? To be changed. Oh, hallelujah. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, you shall be changed at the sound of the last trump, and this mortal will take on immortality, and this corruption shall take on incorruption, and we shall all be changed. Oh, hallelujah, I believe that we shall all be changed. Praise be to His holy name. So get ready to say goodbye, because one of these days, oh hallelujah, that old grave site that swallowed up a loved one, oh guess what? Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Jesus says, I have the keys to death, hell, and the grave. And we're going to meet our family once again, or our loved ones, those that have passed on before us. Oh, praise be to God in the name of Jesus. They're already up in heaven enjoying, hallelujah, that place that Christ prepared for us. But for us that are still here on earth, we can still partake, oh, hallelujah, setting our mind upon our heavenly place where we walk upon. Oh, hallelujah. I found out in the Bible that they paved their streets with gold. I found out in the Bible that the 12 foundations of the New Jerusalem, that it is made up of particular stones, and all 12 of those stones are the only stones that allow the reflection of light to go through them to create a rainbow. See, God owns the rainbow. Get heaven on your mind. Be steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for it is so much that you know that your labor is not in vain. He's coming back, and He has a reward for you and for me. Hallelujah. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing His mercy and His grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, He's prepared for us a place. How many of you believe this today? Hallelujah. Praise. Get heaven on your mind. C.S. Lewis said this, if you read in history, Christians who did the most for the present world were the ones who thought the most of the next world. He went on to say, when Christians cease to think of the other world, they become ineffective in this one. We need our minds occupied upon heaven. It doth not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when He appears, we shall see Him, and we shall be like Him, for we shall see Him as He is. Listen to this. And every man that has this hope in him purifies himself. You know why we have a generation today that doesn't think that purity matters? Because they don't believe Jesus is returning. They've gone ahead and worked that theology out. That he's not returning. It's like it used to be. It's like it's always been. He's not coming back. So I can live like I want to live. Amen? But 2,163 times the Bible talks about Christ's coming to catch us away out of this old world. And I'm thinking, if you're thinking about that all day long, 2,163 times, you're probably going to think, oh, I better live right. It could be today. It could be today. I can only imagine what my heart will feel. Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or will I, will I in awe just be still? Will I stand in your presence, or on my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Or will I be able to speak at all? I didn't come up with those words, but I can only imagine. Right? The Bible says in Revelations 13 and 6 that Satan opened his mouth to blaspheme God. And these three things it says: to slander God, to slander and speak against his name and against his dwelling place, his tabernacle, and those who dwell in heaven. You see, the enemy slanders three things according to that verse: God's people, God's person, and God's place. He loves to slander heaven. Why? Because he was evicted. He was cast down and evicted out of the third heavens into the second heaven. He was evicted. So think about this for a moment. He knows what heaven is like. And he's been given the boot. And so now he slanders heaven because he knows the glory. He knows the unthinkable, unfathomable glory of God and what heaven looks like. And remember this, he can't create. He can't create a heaven. He's been booted out of it. So he slanders the people, he slanders God, and he slanders heaven. Because he's been booted out and he's no longer able to go there, so he blasphemes. Hallelujah. He tries to destroy, and it must be maddening to him for us as the church and as the body of Christ who once had a home. Hallelujah. Up in heaven, he's been kicked out. But guess what? We're going back there. Hallelujah. As the saints and the heirs and the joint, oh, glory be to God, the heirs and the joint heirs of Christ, as the sons and the daughters. So he knows that we're going back to the place that he was kicked out of. So he slanders and tries to blaspheme and tries to destroy the body of Christ, and down to a more personal level. Ever me and you. And Satan hates the new heaven and the new earth. Hallelujah. Envision, I want all of you to just close your eyes for a minute and envision the most beautiful place you've ever been. Maybe complete with palm trees and raging, beautiful, blue, crystal clear water, jagged mountains and waterfalls, and maybe snowdrifts. Nah, forget those. But it's just gorgeous. Think of your friends. Think of your family members who love Jesus. They're running to you with open arms. Picture them as you're walking together in this beautiful, beautiful place. Oh, and by the way, you have a new body. Let's not leave that one out. So you literally are walking around and running and sprinting and flying, you know, and you ain't got to worry. You ain't got to wear a mask, okay? There's no sickness. You ain't got to have your bottle of Motrin. There's no pain. You don't need your laughing pills. Okay. Yeah. You're reminiscing. You're holding, you're hugging. But someone is coming, and it's Jesus. He's got a big smile on his face. And I want to see, hallelujah, right now. We're falling on our knees. But he pulls you up and he embraces you and he tells you, welcome home, son or daughter. You've entered into the joy of the Lord. You don't want to leave there. Uh-uh. You just had heaven on your mind right there. Heaven on your mind. Oh, hallelujah. Revelations chapter 21 tells us what will not be in heaven. I want to tell you today there'll be no funeral homes in heaven, because the undertaker is going to put the undertaker out of business. Okay? There'll be no hospitals. You're going to be unemployed, folks. There'll be no divorce courts, no bankruptcy courts, no addiction centers. No teen suicide, drug problems, or shootings, or terrorism, or prejudice, or injustice, or, you know what I'm talking about, misunderstandings, and hurt feelings, and offenses, and arguments, and all those worry and depression, and breakdowns, and all those things. They will not be there. I just felt a sense of relief right there. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Let's stand today. Praise his holy name and keep heaven on your mind. There'll be no tears because he's going to wipe away every tear from your eye. No sorrow, no sickness, no death, no crying, no pain. For God shall wipe away every tear. Hallelujah. I've heard some say that there'll be no memory in heaven. I think it'll be a little different. We'll have memory, but we'll have a different perspective. We'll remember, but we'll rejoice. Oh, hallelujah, in our final state, as the children of God, we'll rejoice. Hallelujah, in our Savior. We'll rejoice in the one that redeemed us. We'll rejoice in his name, knowing that we shall forever and forever and forever be able, hallelujah, to worship his name and to thank him for redeeming us. Oh, hallelujah, for redeeming us and setting us, hallelujah, in the heavenly places with him. Praise his holy name today. We worship him in spirit and in truth. Behold, I make all things new. He says, when you get to heaven, he'll make all things new. Hallelujah. He says, and now I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth, they passed away, and there was no more sea. Oh, hallelujah. There was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared. It has been prepared as a bride, adorned, hallelujah, for her husband. And then I heard a loud voice saying, behold, the tabernacle of God, the tabernacle of God is with men. Oh, hallelujah, it's no longer in heaven, but it's with men. It's among men. He will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. Listen, and God himself will be their God. And I love the fact that he says in Revelation chapter 22, he says, and there shall be no night there. Oh, hallelujah. Verse 5, they shall not need a lamp or a light or the sun, for the Lord God will give his light. Listen, and they, you and I, will be with Jesus, and we shall reign. We shall reign. We shall reign forever and forever and forever and forever. forever. Get your mind upon that today. Oh, hallelujah. Get yourself out of the depressed Molly Grubbs. That's what you're facing today is nothing in comparison to the glory. Is nothing in comparison to the glory. Is nothing in comparison to the glory which you will experience. Oh, hallelujah. Forever and forever and forever. See, this is more real than what you see right now. It's not a fairy tale. It's real. We need to stand upon the promises of God. If you're having a bad day, you need to go up there. He invites you. He invites you. He says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. Lean not under your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him. Oh, hallelujah. And those that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. And that peace that passes all understanding shall keep them. And as a matter of fact, it's going to guard their heart. Hallelujah. It's going to guard their heart. Hallelujah. From focusing upon the bad things I hear on earth and what seems insurmountable. Guess what? We serve a God of miracles. We serve a God that is able and much more abundantly above and beyond what you can ask or think, and he shall supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory. Quit thinking about how you're going to get it done here on earth and get your head up there. Get your head in heaven and see that God has already supplied, that God already has the resources. Hallelujah. He supplied 2,000 years ago on the cross of Calvary, and our Heavenly Father owns it all. He owns it all, and sometimes he calls it in and he blesses you with it. And praise be to God. He is a God today that's able to do much more abundantly above and beyond what you can ask or think.